spirit. They that worship me shall worship me in spirit and in truth. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. The letter kills, but the Spirit gives life. Bishop College, it has always been as much spirit as it has been place. Born in the aftermath of the Civil War, nurtured in the nascent days of Reconstruction, embracing generations of those ravenous to dream dreams of a better and brighter future. That is the spirit of Bishop. That spirit gave opportunity to those who had little opportunity.
As the school was founded in 1881, I think it received birth out of a crisis that were in community. You're right on the heels, if you will, of the Emancipation Proclamation about 15 or 16 years. And African-American persons didn't have the opportunity of going to many, many other institutions. And so it was founded by persons who saw the need for academic excellence that would nurture the total person for functioning, for operating in community in a holistic manner. And I think in that sense of equipping and nurturing persons for liberation, for empowerment, I think that as preachers became a part of it, church involvement totally became a part of it. It is to me, if you will, the spirit of Christ, the spirit of the Lord is up on us.
The name Bishop itself, for many, carried a great deal of respect, and it still does in many places and in many ways. And so the spirit of Bishop College is one of true fellowship, true brotherhood, and a commitment to spiritual excellence, in a sense, to the extent that we take great delight that many times the reputation has been that if one is a graduate of Bishop College, that they are genuinely or generally a good preacher. And so that's a great reputation to have.
At Bishop College, impressionable young minds were exposed to the very best in scholarship. A brilliant and remarkable constellation of theological genius gathered on the campus. Those who had studied with the iconic theological minds of the 20th century brought that awareness to the Dallas campus.
The people who shaped me theologically and religiously in study were persons like Milton Curry, who was the president of Bishop College and who was a scholar himself. The dean of religion and philosophy at the time was Harry S. Wright, who taught me my first religion courses as well as my pastoral care courses. And then that was T.W. Thompson in New Testament, Old Testament. John D. Mangle, one of the most influential theological and philosophical minds to date, was at Bishop College.
We had outstanding professors in the religion department. We had tremendous guys who had studied with some of the master scholars in the nation, like Harry Emerson Fosdick and Tillich and so forth up at Union, all over the country. And so they really did give us a thorough education.
Bishop College was not just about formal classroom teaching. The shaping, molding, affirming, and challenging took place in individual conversations, offices, homes, churches, and casual encounters on campus.
They poured in so much into your life. It's like, how do you forget the neighbor who really helped to steer you in the right direction, and that was always there for you? How do you forget a Dean Rollins who literally helped to turn your head, your mind in the right direction? You know, how do you forget Dr. Seals, Dean Seals, that's what we called him, Dean Seals, who made church history swallowable. You know, he would put it in the context of preaching, not something that was really laborious, but he showed us how that we could take church history and use it within the confines of our preaching, and he made it fiery.
Many of the guys came from the same socioeconomic background with the hunger and thirst to be the best, to really improve their gifts. You're sharing your limited resources together. That creates a community that never dies. I don't care how far and how wide you go. That spirit continues to linger. And that's one of the other uniquenesses of that campus.
Tolstoy asked the big question. Whether it is the times that make the men or the men that make the times, Bishop College brought through the Carr P. Collins Chapel a continuous cadre of the greatest preachers that shaped the minds of men who would themselves become the leading pulpiteers in America.
Additionally for me, Bishop College exposure to the creme de la creme of academic, theological, and scholarly work. I can remember my freshman year, my first L.K. Williams Institute, and Sandy F. Ray preaching to the minister's license. I'll never forget that experience. To see how venerated he was, and then to see his presence in the pulpit, it was life-changing, revolutionized. I didn't know a preacher looked like that. But to see that made an indelible imprint on me.
We were exposed to some of the best thinkers of our time. We've heard so many tremendous preachers in the Carl P. Collins Chapel at that time.
It was, for me, the most deepening experience that I have ever had, even today. And I'm almost 30 years removed from Bishop, but there is something about Bishop College that resonates so deeply within the spirit of a Bishop graduate that it almost seems like yesterday that we were there.
Apart from ecclesiology and theology, athletic events and competition demonstrated the holistic emphasis of the college and featured football players such as Bobby Moten, who would later play for the Denver Broncos. In the exciting days of the Bishop gridiron, such greats as Emmett Thomas, defensive coordinator for the Atlanta Falcons, or Otis Taylor, wide receiver for the Kansas City Chiefs, lined up on both sides of the football in those memorable games. Indeed, the Bishop basketball team went to the NAIA tournament during competitive days with the round ball. These endeavors only underscored the overall spirit of triumph and victory, affirmation and encouragement that belong to the whole life of Bishop College. The spirit of Bishop, once a place and now a spirit, a triumphant, indomitable spirit that burns in the hearts and souls of men and women around the world, a spirit that once again can find a place to preserve that spirit, a place that will protect, nurture, ensure, and guard that spirit for generations. There is a place of history, beauty, stability, faith, legacy, openness, commitment. A place that wants to provide a place for the spirit of Bishop. A place where the spirit can burn brightly for the ages to come. A place that will embrace, guard, and guarantee that for eras and epochs ahead, the name and spirit of Bishop will burn. Almost as old as the nation itself, Georgetown College sits in the bluegrass region of Kentucky, surrounded by natural beauty and nestled in the heart of Middle America, set aside enough to be unique and yet central enough to be accessible. Here is a place for the spirit of Bishop to burn. But why? President Bill Crouch considers it a matter of testimony.
My motivation comes from a deep personal experience and also comes as a professional educator. I grew up in Jackson, Mississippi during the 50s. I was almost 12 years old before I ever went into a restaurant that didn't have 4 bathrooms and 2 water fountains. I saw a lot of pain. I saw a lot of showdowns between whites and blacks as I was growing up. And my father, who was a pastor, was very troubled by this. And I remember on an Easter Sunday with him in his white suit, saying to my father as I made a profession of faith and walked down the aisle, that I felt God calling me to make a difference in the world in terms of race relations. My best friends through college and seminary and life have been African Americans. But it wasn't until recently that I began to understand how to celebrate and communicate with these brothers in Christ, brothers and sisters in Christ. So that's the personal. The professional, as an educator, I know that in a diverse world that we now live in, we must learn to live with each other. I can no longer raise my head high in pride at an institution that is focused on educating only one race. I can no longer be a part of an educational enterprise that's not multicultural, because that's the world that we live in. And I'm trying to balance this educational philosophy. How can a person be truly educated if they live on a college campus for 4 years and their roommate is just like them? And so my dream and vision is to create a campus, a residential college in the heart of America, where people of all different cultures, all different skin colors, all different faiths can come together and learn from each other in the context of the Christian faith.
Dr. Crouch has propelled Georgetown into the forefront of studies in African American culture with his establishment of the Underground Railroad Research Institute, which celebrates the role of African Americans as creators of American history. In addition, under the leadership of President Crouch, Georgetown has established an abiding relationship with Regent's Park College of Oxford University. Over the last 2 summers, more than 50 persons have attended Proclaimer's Place at Regent's Park, all because of the visionary leadership and initiative of Dr. Crouch. A further example of Dr. Crouch's visionary leadership is seen in the association with the Cincinnati Bengals. Their summer camp takes place on the campus of Georgetown College. The relationship, the stadium, and the camp all belong to the leadership of Dr. Crouch. Consider these words from Cincinnati Bengals head coach Marvin Lewis.
Well, I am here representing the Cincinnati Bengals and just our summer home and partnership with Georgetown College. And what a pleasure it is for us here as the Bengals to be here in Georgetown, Kentucky, and on the college campus. And just our home away from home. And everybody just bends over backwards to do everything they can to make this just a tremendous experience for our players and a great working environment for us.
Dr. Crouch brings that same visionary leadership to the proposed Bishop Center for African American Ministry.
It will be focused on youth, seasoned people, and the laity. And it will be a totally unique form of education in the United States.
To see it immortalized at some college, university, seminary, attempts of this have been made in the past. But to legitimately sustain it as an operative, viable, and meaningful place for men and women to go and experience the uniqueness of Bishop College. Like the hymn said, just the peace you see will make you feel just as good. It doesn't have to be the whole institution. It could just be a piece of it. That's how significant and unique it is.
I hope that in some way or another, we can pass on to other preachers that type of legacy and that kind of commitment to preaching, that they will be committed in their academics, that they will be committed in their excellence, and that they'll be committed in a personal way to connect with others so that they can mentor them along the way.
I am a pastor in Kentucky and grew up here in Dallas, and I had hoped to go to Bishop. I grew up with the culture of Bishop College here. However, because of circumstances with Bishop, I wasn't able to attend. However, I have lived with that regret over my spirit that I wasn't, grew up right here in Dallas and wasn't allowed the privilege to be able to attend Bishop. But as it refers to, relates to the project that Georgetown is attempting, I'm on board because one of the important things about Bishop was that Bishop gave people a second chance. When you think of, second of all, I'm on board because of what Bishop did in terms of enculturating excellence and what it meant to be the pride, what it meant to be a Bishop graduate. Third, my life has been indirectly influenced by the power of what Bishop did in the lives of other people. Persons like Major Jemison, Melvin Wade, persons like Manuel Scott, but probably the greatest influence on my life was Dr. Cecil Clark, who was a Bishop graduate, who came to Bishop without a high school diploma, and Bishop gave him an opportunity not only to attend, but to matriculate there. And now, through shaping Dr. Clark, my ministry and my life to unlimited extent has been shaped by his ministry, both pastoral and preaching. And so I'm on board with Georgetown College because I think that this project will give us an opportunity in some sense to give persons who need that second chance a chance, persons who want an individual attention, persons who want to be poured into, persons who want to be shaped and influenced by people who've been there, who know what to say and know how to help.
Dr. Crouch and Georgetown College will provide the site, the resources, and the impetus for a Bishop Center for African American Ministry. From vacant ground at the Georgetown campus, perhaps this verdant green lawn will emerge a building, an educational facility to be designed by an African American architect, a place for the spirit to be rekindled, preserved, persevere, and burned for generations to come. The spirit of Bishop, rising like a phoenix from the hearts of those who are keepers of the flame, will find its incarnation in the solid stone of a new place, a perpetual dwelling place for the Bishop legacy, a place that will forever be true to the spirit of the good old Bishop Blue.